When it comes to hamburger menus, we want to make sure that they're accessible, progressively enhanced, semantic, and that they're big enough for the human thumbs to tap them. A lot of hamburger menus I see are too small, or they're so close to the logo that you hit the logo instead and you get redirected to the homepage. But our hamburger menu will be really nice without those problems. And we have our navigation that we coded in the previous tutorial, and we're going to add a hamburger menu on it right now. And our cutoff is going to be at 848 pixels. As you see, it seamlessly disappears whenever the viewport is narrow. And the menu expands when tapped or clicked on, and it is clearly marked that it's expanded with the expanded text, and it changes its background color. And it's still big enough so that you'll be able to tap it with no problems. It also works with JavaScript turned off, which is important for progressive enhancement. So let's get started. Now, the first thing we want to do is code our button. So we want to add the button inside the nav element, because sometimes users will jump to navigation using the keyboard, and they want to be able to find the button to expand the navigation. So we have here our nav element with the logo inside, and we also have the navigation, which is just a list. Now I'm going to put the hamburger right here. And that's another thing that's important for accessibility, is when users tap on the hamburger menu and they press the space bar and they press tap again, then they'll right away redirect it to the navigation, which is very important for accessibility. Now, the first thing we're gonna do is use a button element. Now, don't use a link or I or any other element, just use a button. And we're going to give it an ID of hamburger. And we're going to give it aria expanded true. Now this is going to be its default value, which we're going to change with JavaScript later on. All right. Now it looks kind of crazy, but it will look much better soon. Right, now let's close our button. And there we go. And let's say menu. There we go. We have a nice looking hamburger menu here, which doesn't do anything, but at least it's working. Now, what I want to do now is add the hamburger icon. And I'm going to get one SVG from material icons and add it to the button. So let's just copy and paste and add it. There we go. Right now it's huge, but we're going to fix that. Now we want to put the menu into a span because we want to be able to style it later. And then we want to add another span that says expanded, so that it's obvious when the menu is expanded. And now what we want to do, so we have the button, we have the icon inside it, and now we want to start styling it. So let's go into our SCSS. I'm using SCSS SAS. You can use just CSS for that. You can copy and paste the code and put it into any CSS preprocessor, and it will translate to normal CSS. So let's start styling our hamburger. We're gonna use its ID. Let's give it a margin, 1m, and just the itself, and we want it in the right corner where usually hamburgers are, so users will be expecting them. And we want the burger to display block. Let's give it a white background. Now the next thing we want to do is we want to remove the default button styles. And we already kind of achieved that somewhat with the changing the background, since the default button's background is those grayish ones. So let's reset the button. You can also Google reset default buttons, and there are very, very excellent snippets on the web. So let's do order none, and that's pretty much it. Let's do font size, increase the font size a little bit, and do a height one so that the text doesn't overlap too much and it's still visible. Now let's go ahead and remove the expanded text here, which we're going to call the expanded text by its ID and display none. It should be working unless I didn't add. Yes, I should have added an ID here. There we go. Let's save and test. Perfect. Now let's continue styling. I want the hamburger menu to be 60 by 60. So let's do SVG. Excuse me, I meant I want the hamburger icon to be 60 by 60. So let's do width and height 60 pixels. There we go. The menu's down there, but we're gonna fix that in a little bit. Next thing we wanna do is style our text. So we're going to target menu and expand it and style it. I like to use small caps for badges and for little pieces of text that are not in a sentence. CodePen's Pro Badge is also in small caps, so that's really cool. And we want to do relative on top 15 pixels, so it goes on top of the menu. Great, see, it's starting to look really nice. Now, next thing we want to do is we want the hamburger menu to appear whenever the viewport is more than 848 pixels. So right now it appears all the time, even when we don't need it. And we want to change that, so let's include our mixin. And if you're not familiar with SAS mixins, they are basically like macros, but very powerful, where you can like macros and classes. So my mixin says if the media is a minimum of 848 pixels, display this content. And I am coding here mobile first, which you should always do. If you're like me and you started programming and coding in 2011 or before that, then you know we used to make websites for computers only. So it takes a while to get used to mobile first, but it's much worth it, believe me. Okay, now let's see. Great. Whenever the viewport is wider than 848 pixels, then we see no hamburger. So this is what the user will see if they open it on their desktop. And if it starts shrinking, there it is. We want to be able to manipulate the area expanded true and false depending on whether the hamburger is collapsed or hidden. So this is also very good for screen readers, because whenever it says false, then the screen reader will say collapsed, and whenever it's true, it will say expanded, like our text over here. So let's start by doing this with CSS. We want to target. Now I'm using this character inside the hamburger CSS block, which basically says if the element has this attribute, then do this. Area expanded true, then we want to change the color. Oops, wrong one. And we want to manipulate the SVG. We want it to say background primary color, and we want it to fill. We can use a variable. Okay, great. So now we're adding styles to the hamburger button when it's clicked. So we want to say if it is clicked, or if area expanded attribute equals true, then execute this block of CSS code, and it ends over here. I'm going to add a comment over here. Okay, now the next thing we want to do is when it's clicked, we want this span elements have a position static, because otherwise they will overlap. And the other thing is we want to have expanded span, and we want it to be block. There we go. It's shown up now. Now let's try to manipulate this attribute and see if it works. Let's do false. Okay, now that's its default state. When you open up the site on your phone or a tablet, this is what you're gonna see. Now let's try when you tap it, how it's gonna change. Great, it's working as expected. Now let's try to hide the navigation. Right now the navigation is always there, even when the user is on a smaller screen, and we want to hide it. Now, the way to do that is a bit tricky, since what we want to do is only hide the navigation if the user has JavaScript enabled. Because if the user does not have JavaScript enabled and they visit the site, then they won't be able to navigate because navigation won't be shown, since it requires JavaScript to turn it on via the hamburger button. So what we're going to do is called progressive enhancement, meaning that you add features to the site, but you always have them have backward compatibility so that users will be able to still use them, use the features, even if they're not at their best user experience, but it's better than none. So that's what progressive enhancement is in a nutshell, but I suggest you read up about it. It's really interesting stuff. And every time you write JavaScript, you should make all your apps progressively enhanced. Okay, so we want to add a class to our body tag whenever JavaScript is enabled. So let's do this. And right now the body has no class, but we're going to add it. And then after the body has a class, we want to hide the navigation based on its class, and we only have the class if JavaScript is enabled. So that's how we make the hamburger progressively enhanced. Right now we want to do JS enabled, and we want to select the main navigation, which is this div over here. We're selecting it, but we're saying only select this div if it is a child of JS enabled class, which is going to be put there via JavaScript. We want to say display none, so don't display the navigation, but if the user is on a wider screen, we want to say display block. Okay, let's see if it's working. Yes, it's working just great. As I am widening the viewport, the navigation is here and the hamburger button is gone. But as I narrow it, it disappears and the hamburger is here, which is great. This is what we wanted. And if I have JavaScript turned on, then the navigation will always be there. So we have done our styling via CSS. Now it's time to make this button functional. Right now, it just shows up, but it doesn't do anything. So we want it to be able to open the navigation when it's tapped or clicked. Now let's write some JavaScript for it. Okay, I want to start with document.addEvent listener. So we're going to be listening. For this function, we basically says on load of your website, execute this line of code, and there we go, perfect. Now let's start coding inside. I'm going to call, that's not CSS, it's JavaScript. I'm going to call the hamburger by its ID. It's my favorite function in JavaScript is document.getElementById. So straightforward. And we want to set a hamburger attribute set attribute area expanded to false. Now you might be wondering why we're doing this. So by default, our hamburger is going to be expanded, since when the site is loading, we don't know if the user has JavaScript enabled yet. So we want the menu to be there, and that will help us make the app progressively enhanced. So we want to collapse the menu if there is JavaScript enabled, and JavaScript will be enabled if the this line of code is executed. Now let me show you, since we have area expanded true right now, if I remove the false, let's save it. Let's do this. Okay, see, I removed this line of code that changes the attribute value to false, and the menu here, it says it's expanded. So we wanted to reverse that whenever JavaScript is loaded, or whenever the window is loaded that loads JavaScript. So let's do false. It's very important for progressive enhancement, so make sure you do that. Now let's add the click functionality. We want to do hamburger. Now on click. Now we're writing the function about what happens if the hamburger is clicked. And now we're testing if this get attribute area expanded. Oops, equals false. Then set this attribute. Expanded. And we want the second argument, which is true or false. We want it to be true. Then else, this, we can just copy and paste this line of code. This dot set attribute area expanded. We want it to be false. And that should do it. Now let's try it out. Okay, so it works. However, it is not displaying the menu. Okay, it is not displaying the menu because we have to write the CSS for it. Now we want to call the hamburger, and we want to say if the area expanded equals to true, also known as if the hamburger is clicked or tapped. Then we want its sibling. The plus sign is used when you want to reference a sibling element, which is main nav, to be set to display block. Okay, let's try it again. There we go. It's working great. Now we can play with this all day and it will work. Awesome. Now let's try it without any JavaScript to see if it works. Let's go live and let's shrink the viewport. Okay, now let's turn off JavaScript. Yes, it's working great. Now users that doesn't have JavaScript will see this menu and it will say expanded. So I urge you to go to your site and check if your menus still work with JavaScript disabled.